That's extraordinary. That is some brilliant engineering.
The next big thing is really going to space and being able to provide better life, safer life on Earth.
It's like that light?
Yeah.
This is crazy. Two fingers.
The dream for many of us here at Rocket Lab is push space exploration as far as possible.
This is the actual?
Yes, this is the thing that is going to go to Venus.
What you're doing here is fundamentally extremely risky. You're changing an industry.
I'm Mohak Shroff, and I'm really excited to learn about how Rocket Lab is built different. I'm here at Rocket Lab to learn about their mission to go to space to improve life on Earth. And I want to understand how they balance these two seemingly conflicting goals of maintaining extraordinarily high quality with actually experimenting, taking risks, and challenging the traditional system of how space travel works.
Hey. Welcome to Rocket Lab.
Hey, thank you. I loved walking in and seeing that quote. The idea of going to space to improve life on Earth, I'd love to understand where that comes from.
It is actually very powerful. We have a lot of issues with natural disasters. And just imagine the power of having satellites that is warning people. And we're helping to develop these satellites. We're launching these satellites and we're building components. When the company started, we realized that there are a lot of things are just not available. Mm-hmm. So instead of going out there and empowering suppliers to do this, why not just hire the best people and do it yourself? There are more than 1,700 satellites in space that have a Rocket Lab logo on it. So now let me show you where the magic happens.
Let's do it.
So this team is building harnesses for satellites, harnesses for components, all of that.
The first thing that strikes me when I enter is how like componentized the place is.
Yeah.
It feels very scrappy. It's like so obvious, like there's like, we're building that, and we're building that.
The logic behind it, you see the shadow boards for the tools, the work instructions, the setup, it's always the same.
Consistency is what you're going for.
100%.
You want to make sure that this is a repeatable process so that you can scale it.
Yes.
This is a clean room.
Yeah.
So this is where we test the spacecraft.
This is the actual?
Yes, this is the thing that is going to go to Venus.
That's incredible. How do you think about something like this making life on Earth better? Like, what is the contribution it has?
The dream for many of us here at Rocket Lab is to push space exploration as far as possible. Like, the real ideal is to take interplanetary exploration from a thing that is, as you say, $1 billion government thing to something that a middle school student can do. If every spacecraft is $1 billion, then you're going to launch one spacecraft every 10 years. What we want to do is, for the same price or less, launch 10 every 2 years. The first time you do this, many of them are going to fail. You're going to learn. The second time, fewer and fewer. By the time you've done this 4 or 5 times, every mission to Mars can be 50 million instead of a billion. And 50 million, the more there are these missions, the more discoveries will be made, the more there'll be a use for the missions, and the more science will advance. And that's what we want to do. And this is really the first nudge along that path.
That's actually a really remarkable insight. The traditional model of space travel has always been this idea of like pushing the boundary of innovation, pushing the boundary of invention, building something that's the smartest, fastest, best. What you're saying, that's actually not your goal. It's sort of an auxiliary goal. The real goal is making it reachable, making it like productionizable, making it repeatable.
Exactly. And that takes its own set of things. So on the design side, for example, you have to make things simple. Making the simple thing is paradoxically harder than making a complicated thing. The $1 billion spacecraft tend to be incredibly complicated.
Because they can be. Because,
exactly. And there's no incentive to then take that and make it more simple, which takes work.
It's what the business needs. It's what the world needs. But ultimately, that leads to a level of advancement that's like totally different. Rather than like ending up with something that's faster, you're ending up with something that's simpler, more beautiful. But then to your point, like you're solving problems in a pragmatic way, given the constraints that are bleeding edge.
Exactly.
Nobody's thinking of.
That's exactly right.
That's remarkable.
Let me show you a rocket.
Yeah, let's go look at this rocket. First thing that strikes me is I'm expecting something the size of like this building.
Yeah. Well, this is a small rocket.
Look. Holy cow! It's like that light?
Yeah.
This is crazy. Like two fingers.
It was designed to be highly flexible, but it can only launch small satellites. So that's kind of how we started. And you know, this year we're going to launch Neutron with 13 to 14 ton payload, over 40 meter high, 7 meter diameters.
So you start off with something really small.
Yeah.
Then as you scale, you've got to sort of adapt to that.
Yeah. And that's what we tell people. To do things right actually saves you time because you don't have to fix it again. Mm. And it allows you to build a premium quality every single time. That's the discipline we expect from our people. And to build beautiful things, make people proud. Basically, you do something and you check it yourself. Everybody feels holistically responsible, and our mission, 100% mission success, speaks for it.
So that's interesting. That's actually challenging a lot of the traditional approach to building things.
Yes.
Right, traditionally, you had somebody go design it, you handed it over to someone who went and built it. Here, you're just basically completely demolishing all those silos.
If we would have applied that approach, we wouldn't be in space yet.
There's a culture that focuses on exceptionalism,
yes,
which is sometimes in conflict with a culture that focuses on innovation. Because what you're doing here is fundamentally extremely risky. You're changing an industry.
If you want to accomplish something, you have to be willing to take risks, and you have to accept that failures happen. So that's why we do a lot of testing. We're making changes to the process. Mm. I would say things fail every day when you do things. Mm. You have to have a culture where it's okay when somebody says, I think there's something not okay. You have to allow yourself to fail. But the thing is, how do you react with this? What energy do you take out of a failure? If you take a positive energy and say, that's great, now I know something that I didn't know before, and you're turning it into this positive energy and making the necessary change and making it fast, that's really the rapid changes, the rapid engineering, and that's really what Rocket Lab is all about. We have launched the first 50 rockets faster than anybody else.
I want to go back to the opening quote, which is exploring space to improve life here on Earth. How do you keep people focused on that?
The company is doing well just because we empower our people to do extraordinary things. And to do extraordinary things, you have to give people a vision and a mission to do this. And it's so powerful if you can come to work and do something that has an impact on all of us.
Advances in communications, Earth observation, atmospheric science, and cutting-edge research are just a few of the ways Rocket Lab is making that a reality.
Thank you. It was great talking to you.
Thank you so much. Yeah, really. Thanks so much.
This was incredible. I got to fulfill a number of my childhood dreams. I held an actual satellite that's going to be on its way to Venus. The phrase I kept hearing consistently was the idea of building things beautifully. Craft really, really matters here. For a company whose core value proposition is that they do operate on extraordinary constraints, they're able to move faster than anybody else. What it seems to come down to are two things. It's the who and the why. They hire extraordinary people, give them a ton of agency, and motivate those individuals with their why, their mission. And then when you put those things together, what you end up with is something built beautiful and truly built different.